Once you've agreed with your doctor that surgery is required to improve your condition, you will then need to have a pre-assessment session in outpatients with a nurse and anaesthetist to assess your general health. Your blood pressure will be checked, and a blood sample and possibly an ECG or electrocardiograph will be taken. All these tests are taken to ensure you are fit and healthy enough to undergo surgery. And if the results are positive, you will be scheduled in for your operation. You should also tell your nurse or doctor about any medication you are currently taking, as you may need to stop taking it for a while before the operation.
They should avoid blood-thinning drugs. There are several drugs that tend to affect clotting, blood clotting. The first are those that the general practitioner deliberately prescribes, or the cardiologist. For example, aspirin-like products. That's not paracetamol, that doesn't fall into that group, but aspirin-like products. Then various other blood thinners, like clopidogrel or others, that actually designed for thinning the blood. Warfarin, important anticoagulant. They need to stop these for a period before surgery, generally between 2 and 4 weeks, because otherwise the surgery would be very difficult. And then the other area is there are some herbal products, some foods that thin blood, for example, garlic, ginseng, ginger, and ginkgo. All of these tend to thin blood. And so it's best if patients can avoid herbal remedies as well. It just helps the surgery and will reduce the bruising and so on. So it needs planning, careful planning, and might require them to speak to the cardiologist or their general practitioner.
Prior to surgery, is there anything you can do to help make the operation a success?
The same as for any operation. Be rested, be well hydrated, having had healthy food to boost up their immune system and their reparatory system.
We know, for example, that smoking particularly is bad for the eyes in thyroid disease. And this has been shown again and again. It's more likely that you'll have eye problems in thyroid disease if you smoke, and that the treatment will be more difficult, and the treatment will be less effective, and the disease will go on for longer and be worse if you continue to smoke. That's a hard message, because stopping smoking is not easy, but it's often people feel, oh, we're always told smokers are the cause of the problem. But in this particular case, it absolutely has been shown that things are a lot worse if you smoke and continue to smoke.
You will receive a letter from Moorfields telling you when and where to report to on the day of surgery. Upon arrival, you will be admitted by a nurse who will check your details and get you ready. You will then be visited by the anaesthetist and doctor to make final checks. If you are having an operation on only one eye, the doctor will check this with you and mark the appropriate eye. After signing your consent form, you will change into a robe, and when the theatre is ready, a nurse will escort you down for your operation. After putting on shoe covers and a hairnet to help keep the theatre sterile, the nurse will hand you over to the theatre staff. When the anaesthetist has administered your anaesthetic intravenously, you will be taken into theatre.